गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स,
आई होप यू ऑल पीपल आर एंजॉयिंग द डे।
टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस और वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ न्यू पोएम वेयर द माइंड इज़ विदाउट फियर, इट इज़ इंक्लूडेड इन योर सिलेबस। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट, इट इज़ बेटर टू टॉक अबाउट द ऑथर। ओके, सो हु इज़ द पोएट ऑफ दिस पोएम? सी, रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर, वन ऑफ द फेमस पोएट from India. Okay, so Rabindranath Tagore was born in Bengal in 1861, and he wrote poems in Bangla language, okay, and in English. In 1913, Tagore was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature for his collection of songs called Gitanjali. So Gita and then Anjali. Tagore is the only Indian to have received the Nobel Prize for Literature. In which year? 1913. Tagore also has the honor of being the composer of the international anthem Jana Gana Mana. The small school he started in Shanti Niketan is now a university. Now it has become a university. Where the Mind is Without Fear is one of the Tagore's better known poems. Tagore was a patriot and loved his country, and on first reading this poem, the reader may get the idea that Tagore is appealing to God to awaken his countrymen to clear reason, truth and understanding. The appeal of the message, however, is universal. The poet is asking God to show the people of the world the way to a better life. So basically the second idea is the theme of the poem, okay, or the message of the poet that is written in this poem. The mind is where the mind is without fear. This is the title of the poem. Okay, see. Okay. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high. Where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Five lines. Where the mind is without fear, the writer says that there must be a world, there must be a country where the people should have a free mind, the people should have no any kind of fear, and the people live a very respectful life, okay, that is held high. You know, the poet says the head is held high. And in another line, in the second sentence, you can say, where knowledge is free. What does it mean? It means everyone must know what's happening around him or her. Okay, everyone must know. Where the knowledge is free, another meaning is that, you know, everyone is allowed to get education. Okay, there will be no any foundation for that. Where the world has not been broken up, he's talking about a unified world. He's talking about a country, unified country. He's not talking about the broken one, you know, small countries into fragments by narrow domestic walls. If we will talk about walls, so we must know about Germany. There was a wall between Western and Eastern Germany. Okay, but here writer is talking about the domestic walls that we have created, and we have made many countries. God has given us a world, and we have made countries. Okay, we have broken up into fragments. Where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. In this line, Rabindranath Tagore says that everything, the countrymen must speak the truth. They should not hide the truth, and the people must strive for the betterment for the people. The people must work for perfection. The people were always think about perfection, and everyone must do their duties 100%. Okay, they must give 100%. Okay, in everything, and they must think about the perfection, because if all the countrymen will do the same, the country will automatically will improve. Okay, and the world will be a better place to live in. Next, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. In this line, Tagore says, Rabindranath Tagore says, that we must have a reason. We must use our intellect. We must use a clear stream of reason that God has provided us. That should not be mingled with emotions. That should not mingle with biasness. That should not mingle with dead habits, you know, bad habits. Okay, our reason, our intellect must be clear. Must be clear. And that should not be mixed up. That should not be the mixture of biasness, prejudiceness, dead habits, bad habits, like that. Our reason should be clear. Okay. In the next line, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever widening thought and action. Where the mind is led, where the people are led, where the heart is led forward by thee, O God, by you, O Almighty, by you, into ever widening thought. Our thoughts should not be limited. Our thoughts should not be so narrow. Our thoughts should be ever widening, you know, free thought. Okay, free thought, freedom of thoughts, you can say, and freedom of action, you can say. That, O God, our mind should be led by you. O God, lead our minds, lead our hearts, lead our actions. And our actions and thoughts should be ever widening. That should not be narrow. That should not be limited. Our thoughts and actions should be unlimited. Okay. Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. So in this poem, father, he said father. Father generally is addressed to God Almighty by the Christian people. Okay. Okay. Here it means Parvardigar, Palanhar, Ishwar, okay. Into that heaven of freedom, O God, lead our mind, lead our hearts, okay. Into the ever-widening thought and action. Into that heaven of freedom, our country or our world should be a heaven of freedom. There everyone will have the equal opportunity there. Everyone will have freedom of mind and thoughts and actions, okay. O God, let my country awake. Now in this line, the last line, he is appealing, he is requesting, he is beseeching to God, Oh God, awake my country, please awake my country. So you can see the last line shows that he is one of the, in the last line we see the patriotism that is in Rabindranath Tagore's heart. Okay, so let my country awake. What he says? He says, let my country awake. Okay. So this is the end of this poem. The theme you have understood that in this poem is a prayer. This poem is an appeal to God, in which the poet appeals to Almighty that, O Almighty, please make a heaven, make a country in which everyone should have equal opportunity to get education. Everyone should have the equal rights of freedom of thoughts and action. Okay, and the last line, that heaven should be what? The people, everyone, every countryman should work towards perfection. Everyone should be very laborious, very smart and very hard working, full of perseverance, and they must work for the perfection. They must work for the betterment. Okay. Okay. And they must give their 100% in improving the what? The lifestyle of the people. Okay, thank you very much, students. I hope you have enjoyed this class, and just wait for the next video. Thank you very much.